Okay, we are about to see how well this little green machine actually cleans couches. This is not sponsored, but my kids just always make a mess, so we need to clean the couch. Today's mess is honey mustard from McDonald's because my son decided to squeeze it all over the couch for whatever reason. The first thing I do is fill up the tank with warm water in solution, emphasis on warm water. I just feel like that cleans it better, but then I spray it all over the couch, especially the areas with the stain. I will like respray it and re-go over it until it's gone. So this was from when the mess was dry, but I should have done it when it was fresh. And here's the results.
Alright, here's my favorite like couch cleaning hack. If you have a couch that stinks, maybe you have dogs, maybe you had someone with a stinky booty sit on your couch, I don't know, but here's what I do. I take baking soda, sprinkle it all over my couch. You can do a little bit or you can do a lot, just depends on, you know, I guess how stinky your couch smells. I do the cushions on top of here, I do the arms, I do the seats right here. Ooh. Yeah, all over. This also helps with like water stains. Maybe your dog was wet and sat on your couch. Maybe you spilled water or coffee or whatever, and the little like water spots never completely came up. You're gonna vacuum it up. You're gonna grab a spray bottle with white vinegar and dish soap, Dawn dish soap. Spray your solution and rub it in, wipe it away.
The first time I've had a professional in to clean my couch.
Je reteste la fameuse technique pour nettoyer mon canapé. Tout propre.
This is how I clean my couch. No, this is not an ad. I just need to show you how amazing this thing is. It's so satisfying. You're gonna want one, especially if you have a pet like I do. First step is to strip the couch. I use this all natural spray to spray the inside of the cushions that can't go in the washing machine. It neutralizes odors and is safe for my dog. I wash the cushions and blankets separately to use different temperatures. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. It's so easy to use. All you have to do is fill up the solution tank with warm tap water. You can use whatever cleaning solution you prefer. I've been using this one, which is the one that came with it. You pour it into the cap, and then you use that to pour it into the solution tank, and then you put it back together. The cord is super long, which makes it easy to plug in just about anywhere. Then you unravel the hose, turn it on, and get to work. Like I said, super easy to use. Once I do an entire cushion, I go back over and remove any excess moisture that I can. The suction on this thing is really good. After the first cushion, the water looks like this. How gross. This is the water after two cushions, and I cleaned this couch just a few months ago. Once the couch is done, I use whatever solution is left to spot treat the corner of my ruggable that gets the most foot traffic. The hardest part is just waiting for it to dry. And once it's dry, I reassemble the couch. I have all of the products I used in my cleaning and home Amazon list, which is linked in my bio.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Grace and Creighton, and we flip sofas to pay off our mortgage. We got this one for free off Nextdoor. Shout out to David, who's retiring to Florida. Thank you so much. The sofa is 27 years old, so she needed a little bit of TLC. We started with rubbing alcohol on a microfiber to get out these paint stains. Then I started working on this stain. I don't know what it was, except for just super annoying. I just kept on working on it. It didn't want to go anywhere. I just gave up at the end. It's fine. It's fine. And then, of course, I had to include this clip because this 27-year-old sofa looked brand spanking new after I went over it with my Bissell. It's too good. And that right there, that's ink. I got that out. Again, microfiber, rubbing alcohol. It's insane. Some spots just needed like a little Resolve spray, a little elbow grease, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. It came out just fine with my Bissell. And then last but not least, you got to flush all that grime away so you can enjoy the end product. Violet loved it, but we ended up selling it for $510. What up, what, so she said, make some time for me, see for this, let me and you tap like hush for me. We walk in they stare, please show them your best. Why do we flip sofas when the hourly rate sometimes isn't good? I'll show you why we do it. I love spending time with this guy every day. Any time that we get to spend together is awesome. We get to record funny videos, which we find funny. I don't know about you guys. While I'm working on the sofa, Creighton can work on his cars, so I get to be outside. I love to clean. I love my dog Lily, and I love my dog Violet. And that's Steve. He's not our dog. He's our friend. And the whole thing just makes us really excited and happy, and we hope that you guys enjoy it as much as we do. I was good on my own, that's the way it was. That's the way it was. You was good on the low for a faded fuck. I'm so faded love. Shit, what the fuck you complaining for? Feeling jaded up. Used to trip off that shit I was kicking to you. Had some fun on a run, though I'll give it to you, but baby. I have to have a machine washable couch because my dog's faces are just too cute and I can't tell them no when they ask to get up. I could tell it was definitely time to deep clean the couch, so I went through and took off all of the covers on the pillows and every single part of the couch that I could detach so that I could throw it in the washing machine. I put it all in the washer and wash it on a cold temperature with a little bit of detergent and some vinegar. Then I just throw it all in the dryer at low heat and put all of the covers back on. I do this about once a month and it feels so nice to have my couch super white and clean again, but it won't last too long.